cancer is the second largest cause of death among men in North America. It's a health crisis in true sense. A standard treatment of prostate cancer is a type of surgery where small instruments and cameras are sent inside the patient's body through small holes. To perform the surgery, a surgeon sits on a chair, looks at a screen displaying the camera image, and very intuitively controls the surgical instruments. And this is what a surgeon sees. At the top, the central blob-like structure is the cancerous prostate, which is encapsulated by important structures responsible for sexual function and continence function. The goal of the surgeon is to take the cancerous prostate out while keeping the attached structures intact. However, this is not trivial simply because these structure boundaries and cancer is not visible in the camera image, as you can see. The cancer is inside the prostate. And here comes my PhD, where the goal is to display the tumor locations on the camera image itself. At the bottom, on your left, you see the same setup in lab settings, but on a fake prostate model. Blue is the prostate. In the middle, you can see like the MRI of the same prostate model. And this MRI is annotated for cancer by a radiologist. And on the very right, you see my augmented reality system where MRI can be seen, on which in red is the visible cancer. It's the cross section of the phantom, so a surgeon can see inside of the prostate. And this MRI can be controlled in real time using the surgical instrument. Now, some technical nitty-gritties. Technically, the goal is to find the alignment between the MRI and the camera. MRI is taken at a different facility than where the surgery is performed. We already know the alignment between the MRI and the robot. Now, the goal of my PhD is to estimate the alignment between the robot and the camera so that I can show the MRI in correct orientation and perspective, as you see in the rightmost image. So how did I do that? I estimated a few data points from robot's perspective. I estimated the location of the same data points from camera's perspective, and then found a mathematical mapping between the two. And boom, we had our augmented reality system that you can see here. The MRI plane can be controlled in real time using the surgical instrument and is completely inside of the patient. In fact, a previous version of the system has been tested in 12 patients so far at Vancouver General Hospital, where we showed the virtual and real side by side. And I'm very happy to say the system that started with someone's small vision years ago is ready to be tested inside of the first patient as soon as COVID situation allows us. Thank you.